After like a few hours of this discussion back and forth, mainly they seem to be discussing borders and some such. They both seem fine to establishing what they would call like a neutral zone behind their areas, and basically not venturing into the others without permission and such. But then they both turn again to you, the party, and the asks. We have a preliminary set of borders you know of. The question is then, Alauneari of House Vytharia, what are your plans for the future?
Well, and there he looks at the two, and bows and says, we have now spent quite a bit of time in the fungal jungle. Our plans have always been to root out the barrenness of Vothys, and then to return down below to reforge the way our brethren and our race acts and behaves. We were exiled for our differences, and we will return to rectify that mistake. The Zyn and the Gizral are indeed great peoples, and it would be a great alliance between our three peoples to keep all of us safe and protected from one another and from outside threats.
The alchemist seems to think the Xan are not prepared to fight your wars for you, Drow. This is something I have said before, and I have not changed my mind on this.
That is all right. We do not expect you to fight for us. Only that when the war is fought, you and won, you have a different opinion about what has changed. Make no mistake, we have no interest in this jungle, or we would have done everything to keep it divided. Our concerns are below, to make the ancient city of Tarisia and the nobles therein answer for what they did to our family.
Alchemist seems to nod, taking this more or less as face value, it seems.
Regardless of that, the problem is still Vothys. Should we fail and be left alone, there will be more nobles to oversee Vothys, more who will always have this sort of a desire to cast their eyes outward, and they'll see the jungle, and they'll look to divide you again. No matter what happens to us, communication is the most important to keep yourselves united against whatever threats exist outside.
The alchemist seems to consider this, and the white spider as well. And then the alchemist, you know, turns to the party and says, do you have a plan to take care of said baroness?
Well, Neri considers this. She continues.
And if you do, what guarantee do we have that you do not turn and become as her?
Well, Neri, we'll start with the first question. We have a small force ourselves stationed south of Vothys. It is perhaps not enough to take the city by itself, but we will make a try if that is what is needed. Looks at the others. If we had a stronger force, or even as we go with this what we have, we do not expect everyone in Vothys to be loyal to the Baroness. We will give them the offer to join us and to live, or to continue fighting for her and to be in mortal danger. Perhaps this will make enough of them realize their futility of continuing to fight for the Baroness, and thereby they would join us. That would give us an edge. Besides that, we know that there is a large garrison at the gate into the fungal jungle, The soldiers of Vothys are right now divided. This plan could be done there as well, taking care of one group of enemies before we move on the other. How we can promise we are not going to be as the Baroness, does this not prove it? She sort of gestures to the two. If we were indeed to become that, then an alliance between the Zyn and the Skizral would be the greatest threat to us, as it is to her now.
Considering our races, history, and what you've seen of our culture for so long, there are no words that we could ever give you which would make you wholly trusting of us.
The alchemist nods, as well as the spider. That is true. We have a long and sordid history, as we have discussed before. He looks around. But I can see some of the wisdom in your words. It is still peculiar, and I am not exactly sure at what angle you are playing this. However, the concern of Vothys still stands. It is a impressive border keep, if you will. They have impressive defenses. The moat and a drawbridge and the walls. Plus the tower itself. Turning the garrison against the Baroness, perhaps. I could not speak to the inhabitants' loyalty to her. That would be more your expert area, I do believe.
Alauneari nods. It is a city of outcasts, most. Many who would not hold loyalty to much. She must, by now, have quite a hardened core, however, so some will surely stay. The average soldier will, if faced with a force that could threaten his life, most likely at least put down his arms and be neutral in the battle to see who wins. In short, not many would be willing to lay down their life to protect her.
The alchemist seemingly shrugs and says, perhaps the loyalties of the drow are something you know better than we, as I said. If you do believe that you can turn some of the garrison, well, good luck to you, I suppose. Yeah. Looks over to the white spider. Seems to have been listening, not saying too much. And then she says, as for this Skizral, we are concerned with the Baroness and her plots. She has been a destabilizing factor that is clear to me, and as such I would like to see her removed. I am sure that whatever comes after her would not be as bad as she is. So looks over at the alchemist. I am prepared to form this treaty of peace and ceasefire with your alchemist, and perhaps in a few cycles we can meet again to discuss more internal matters. The alchemist seems to again sort of consider this and say, I have a few items that could aid in such a communication. We can discuss the details later. The white spider seems to agree to this. And then say, very well then, as we discussed, we will respect our current borders. There will be a zone of neutrality between us, and people are free to move through our territory with permission, of course. Aside from that, we are to steer clear of each other. Alchemist nods. That seems workable for us as well. They both seem to nod. Very well. Let us then proclaim the Xan and the Skisral war over. And from now on, we shall move forward, not as enemies, but as neighbors. He sort of seemed to smile. The White Spider nods. As you say then, neighbors.
Alauneari nods to this as well.
Yeah. The alchemist seems to, again, you know, consider this and say, I will be in touch in the future then. He sort of looks over at you. It has been a fruitful day. I am pleased that I was convinced to come to this meeting. So, looks over the party. Very well then. Priestess, looking over at the White Spider, and then he glances over to Larry. Matron.
She nods. Alchemist.
And then he, you know, slowly turns around. And walks ponderously up to his people.
A quick shudder as he walks.
Yep. There seems to be a little bit of movement up there. And, the White Spider retreats back to her people as well. And then you see, you know, they seem to be both gathering up something. And the alchemist, you know, they walk towards each other again slowly. The alchemist is holding out what seems to be, you know, some sort of orb. It's like a crystal ball thing almost, like it's shining slightly. He bows towards the White Spider and hands her the orb, which she picks up, and in return gives him. What seems to be like almost like a rolled up bolt of silk, but you can clearly see that there's a lot of sort of embroidery and things on it. It is rolled up though, so you can't really see the whole motif. And they both bow to each other. And turn towards you and say, very well then, you have borne witness to the birth of this alliance, and know that the people of the Fungal Jungle are behind you in your endeavors, House Vytharia. Although we will not fight your wars for you, we seem to have a common enemy at this point. And our alliance, we would extend towards you as well. As long as you abide by the basic tenets, no wars of conquest or some such, diplomacy, trade, everything of this is possible. But any aggression by any other party of the Alliance, and the others will attack.
Well, Mary bows and says, then let us consider this not an alliance between two people, but an alliance between three. The Drow of House Vytharia, the Skisral of the White Spider, and the Zan of the Alchemist. of you. We agree to these terms, and as soon as the common enemy in Vothys has been taken care of, we can perhaps meet again to discuss trade and other such terms.
They both seem to not. Thus was the Treaty of House Vytharia formed in the Upper Asethir, binding the three factions of the jungle in an alliance.
Yes.
Truly momentous occasion.
Truly momentous occasion.
Oh, we need like a Federation flag.
Mm-hmm.
We need to draw a flag.
You still need your house sigil.
Yeah, like the sigil and then the Zen and the Skizral symbols on it.
Yeah, a treaty is drawn up, like a very official document. It is marked with a rune of the White Spider. The alchemist seems to put his mark on it as well, and it is extended towards Alauneari.
She will put the family symbol on it as well.
Okay. Very well. The treaty is formed. Lovely. After this has been happened, you know, the entourage of the different factions, they seem to. Some of the ice is definitely broken. They're still certainly very suspicious against each other, but at least, you know, they're trying.
They have less feeling that one's going to instantly murder them.
Exactly. And something of a half formal dinner in improvised dinner takes place between the the different factions. Everyone breaks bread, whatever bread they want, and sit around and talk and mingle for basically the rest of the night.
Break mushrooms. And meat.
Break mushrooms or meat, whatever you want.
This is the strangest thing, the strangest game with the strangest drow.
So we're having a dinner party with a giant spider and a giant plant.
Yes, talking about an alliance, a mutual beneficial coexistence.
For the 4,067th time since he was born, Rilinid contemplates. What the hell am I doing?
4,060. Yeah, that's like. Once every few days.
Well, he has lived for over 100 years, so, you know, gotta spread it out.
Yeah, like, ugh.
This again.
Trust me, where the hell is Zin's, like, high table that we've been watching this from?
He suddenly just, like, rolls out, shoots them both.
Rapid shot,
succeeded.
Exactly. Oh.
As the treaty says, we now inherit the land.
I'm not sure the treaty says that, actually.
Personal union.
We will integrate their empires into our own.
Biological and technological distinctiveness will be added to our own.
Yeah, clearly with my linguistics, I added that subclause in there.
We go for the green light and refuse them together.
The synthesis option. Well, or, you know, Alauneari can marry the alchemist, of course.
Like the drow. We return to Vothys, but we have, like, we've all got 8 legs and, like, plant growths everywhere.
So, yeah, during this more informal meeting during the evening, it seems like at least the White Spider wants to talk more about your plans with Vothys.
Oh, sure.
Okay.
As she says, she is very much interested in removing the Baroness. Okay. And she explains that given a workable plan, she will consider putting some of her soldiers to your disposal for this.
So I think with Manaki's statement there, we're actually hoping for as minimal bloodshed as possible. We do know the sort of like the defenses and everything constructed rather well, given how we've lived there for like half of our lives.
You can go now to the new map I've revealed called Vothys and take a look.
We can plan our battle plan.
So I assume we'll take the guard tower first, because we can't lead our armies through that like thin passage of going in a line.
I think the sort of main goal we're hoping here for is to assemble such a like powerful force, and you know, like maybe like knowledge there of maybe like even like a siege weapon, or at least enough people, particularly with the skiss roll, that the drow soldiers holding the walls themselves go, nah, this ain't fucking worth it.
Like that's the hope, right? We can stand there and say, oh yes, look at this. This is what you got to deal with if you stay. You can just put down your weapons now, and then you know you won't be hurt.
You do know. First of all, the drawbridge is of course not down most of the time. It is
right.
Up.
Yeah.
These are like ballistas, basically trained on the area in front of it. And this is basically an abyss.
A massive chasm. I remember you telling me that a long time ago.
How wide is the trench?
The trench is... It is wide enough. I mean, how...
Surely spiders could do like the spider web thing.
I think he's like hoping, you know, like they like shoot like webbing across, like attach the wall, then people ferry themselves.
Sure, yeah. if this skiss roll gets time to work, they could certainly probably use their webs to create like rope bridges or ropes to climb onto the walls.
Because in case we can't get this to drop down, that will be our second option.
I mean, like, you know, the first goal is to, like, you know, of course, minimize resources lost, and obviously the Baroness and whatever core she's got, and who knows exactly would be willing to surrender the massive force and who not. Maybe they don't even like the Baroness themselves and would much prefer a change of rule, but with that in mind, we are angling for them just going, okay, fine. But if they don't, you know, rope bridges might be able to get the gnome to do something. Rilinid's got enough knowledge engineering.
It is a cave. The Skisral could just climb over the wall, right? They could just approach Vothys on the ceiling.
Like this?
Yeah, like they would walk on the ceiling.
I know it's a massive cavern. I don't know how big it is. So, like, you know, it might be like, yeah, they can climb above it, but they wouldn't be possibly able to get themselves down.
There's a whole thing where they put web and then, like, sort of glide down or...
Skisrod can certainly try to infiltrate like that.
Because I think the like we will come with our little force of drow, right? And they will be like, ha,
well,
and laugh at us.
It's not just drow. We're looking to like impress some gnomes,
right?
Yeah.
And then we'll go there and we'll like stand and look at the wall, and they will laugh at us. And then suddenly. Like 100 Skisral rappel down.
Well, 100.
Like, well,
I don't
we
think
can get
100 Skisral.
Like onto the walls, and suddenly it's not so funny anymore.
The White Spider does tell you that she will not supply 100 because she does not have 100 soldiers.
There's only like a few hundred Skisral left alive. She can't spare that many hunters.
Yeah.
No, but she will send some of her best. Soldiers, Skisral, to help you out.
Yeah, and I think it, probably having them as terror units first and foremost. I mean, this ground is full of spikes. Is it really a good battlefield?
No, it's pretty terrible. This is the Garden of Barbs.
Yeah.
What we don't want to have happen is
I know that the tower there, from what Jonas said, like overlooks that garden. If we get into a fight and have to slog through that garden, they're going to be shooting at us all day.
Make a knowledge local check.
Ain't got it.
I was recalling information Jonas gave me from knowledge local checks like forever ago.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Let's see here. How about 29?
Oh, jeez. Yes. Well, you know, Rilid being the acquisitor of things.
I had decades. To fucking stare at this shit.
Yeah, exactly. He does know, you know, he made it his business to know what was going on in Vothys for quite some time, after all. He does know a few things about this. First of all, he does know that there is actually a secret entrance to the guard tower here at the base of it.
Oh, yeah?
It is known by some of the guards. Some of the squad leaders have this knowledge. Also, the captain of the guard and the Baroness herself probably knows of this, of course. Like any ranking member of the tower will probably know of this. But this this secret entrance does give you access to the guard spire and the entrance way into the main tower itself from there. He does also know that the guard posts atop this tower are usually not that alert. being up there is considered something of a vacation post.
Nice.
Because it is far away from both the very strict and serious guard captain and, you know, the Baroness herself. As such, someone posted up there takes it like as a day off, and usually descend into either gambling or some sort of carnal orgy up there.
Fantastic.
So how tall is that tower?
Perhaps sneaking into that secret entrance and taking care of that would be.
Well, the concern is like, okay, say that we somehow like ascend up, like, you know, using some sort of magic. I don't think the Skistral are going to haul us. I mean, we're just as big as they are. But assume we can, like, circumvent the wall, then yeah, sure, we could sneak in to deal with the Baroness. But I want to, like, try to square away, like, you know, the soldiers so that we don't just suddenly show up and go, ha-ha, we've killed the Baroness, and they're all like... The guard captain, I think it's, like, Tether Qual, or I don't remember his name. He just, like, loses his fucking mind because we broke into his beloved Vothys. He just kills all of us.
You do know that Captain Tether Qual is something so strange as, like, a dedicated drow. He's very much a straight military man. He is self-made, you know. He is not an exiled noble or something. He basically fought his way into this position from what seems to be, like, you know, almost like slave origins. He is very competent. He is definitely the most seasoned fighter and military mind in Vothys, and he takes its protection quite serious. He is, rumor has it, very concerned about not letting Vothys fall, like not letting it fall into ruin, basically. Such, Rilinid would guess that he's probably not loyal to the Baroness herself.
So much as Vothys.
Yeah, he is more loyal to her position or the integrity of Vothys itself.
Well, in that case, we can definitely get him on our side. We need to present a force which is strong enough that an intelligent, like, you know, informed guard captain like him believes that we could actually take the walls. And with that, promise him that he can keep us post and we'll keep Vothys intact. But we're going after that fucking Baroness and killing her.
Uh-huh. Or we could try to sneak in completely, just circumventing everything, killing the Baroness and pretty much saying, well, We are Baron now. We are Baron.
Well, the problem is, what do we do about the loyalists?
Well, we kill them, of course.
We kill them.
The point stands is we don't want to have to kill the Barons and then, like,
this whole thing.
I imagine she would be in her. I'm sure we've seen, like, the quarters of where the old Baron used to be back when we were invited here decades ago. So we know where her bedroom is.
It is on the top floor,
like right there.
Yeah,
fight through.
Basically, like, this is her throne room, you know, overlooking the Garden of Barbs. Since she took over, you were never allowed access to that top floor, so you don't really know the whatever, you know, changes to layout or anything she has done up there.
So is that like a window?
Yes.
Question: how tall is this tower?
Oh, these questions.
I have a perfectly relevant
reason. The wall is supposed to be really tall.
It is quite tall.
I mean, I think he said something about, like, Vothys, the main tower itself, being, like, five stories. So, like, the turret there is, like, what, maybe four? Three?
Yeah.
I don't know what you're hoping to ask for. Are you hoping to repel?
Use the ballista as a reference.
Yeah. What I'm wondering is, basically, how much of a guard's dark vision is actually obscured just by the fact of height?
They're not paying attention.
Yeah, that is a thing, but how far can they actually physically see from up there?
Well, you do know that illumination of the Garden of Barms is usually something that occurs because, you know, there are crystals and things set into these things that sort of illuminate the pain and suffering of the artwork and sort of cast these haunting shadows. So this area is illuminated.
I assume the walls are also probably illuminated slightly.
They have you know, torches and stuff too, that they can shoot out to extend their dark vision if needed.
And, you know, they want to make the place look as intimidating as it possibly can.
Yep.
Basically, I'm just trying to find blind spots if I can, but...
Mm-hmm.
I think the blind spots were well considered whenever the nobles first constructed this hundreds of years ago.
What about the slave camp?
It's beneath... Beneath Vothys itself, it's underneath it in the caverns.